Okay, we have to prepare these grid lines in the ETAP software. So it is not a uniform kind of a simple grid line, non-uniform kind of simple grid line. It is what the before of this, the two types of grid line that we have seen, it is in Cartesian form. It is in Cartesian form, Cartesian grids, because its a dimension is running in a x direction, y direction in plan. But this is not in Cartesian. This is cylindrical grid line. This is what? It is actually cylindrical grid line. So these kind of grid lines we have to prepare. So it is not the normal case as that of the Cartesian form. It is a cylindrical grids. And we have to prepare this grid line in the ETAP software. So how to create these grid lines? Okay. So just go back to ETAPs. Just go back to ETAPs and go to file. Go to new model. Once you click over the new model, just go to use built-in setting width. Go to third option. Then next one is what? You have to decide the display unit system. So can anyone tell me what unit system you have to refer? So it is a 4 meter like this. So it is in metric system. It is not feet and inches. If the unit system is in feet, units are in feet and inches, in that situation you have to go with the US customary. But if your unit system is in metric SI or in meters, you have to go with the metric SI. Check this one and rest of all the options you know very well. As per your requirement, you have to choose the steel section database, you have to choose the steel design code, you have to choose the design correct design code, concrete design code. Now simply say OK. Once you click over the OK, the quick template will be available here. But now I would like to ask that the grids that we want to prepare here, we want to prepare this kind of grid. So it is Cartesian or cylindrical?
Hello.
Cylindrical.
It is cylindrical exactly. But if you look here, so no option is present. No option is present to form the cylindrical one. So what you will do? So there's no option. Let it be all the things as it is. Just say blank. Choose the blank one and say simply OK. Once you click over the OK, so nothing will be in the view. In any view. Plan view, 3D view. This is a model explorer. What is the application of the model explorer? Okay. That all things we will learn later. Right now we don't need to have this model explorer. So close this. Now we are having the two window. Okay. Two views. There's a plan view and 3D view. Here we also also don't need to have the 3D view. Close this. This is also done. Now clear this all. Then go to edit story and grid system. Once you click here, so by default one grid system is there, G1. Where we have not taken anything. G1 is there. That is the Cartesian one. But here we need to have the cylindrical grid. So what you need to do, just click over add a new grid system. By default, one grid will always be there. So let it be. Just click over add a new grid system. Once you click over the add a new grid system, once you click the add a new system, grid system, okay. And here Cartesian is there and cylindrical is there. Now you are getting the option. Now just click here cylindrical one. Once you click over the cylindrical one, so this kind of requirement values you have to put. So radial direction and tangential direction. Radial direction and tangential direction. Two directions will be there. This direction will be what? This will be the radial direction. This is what radial direction, and these all are the tangential direction. This is nothing but the tangential direction. And this is what, this is the radial direction along the radius, and this is what is the tangential direction. Okay, so two direction is there. Now half part we have to consider only. This half part we have to consider only. Okay, this half part we have to consider. So just try to understand grid labeling. So grid labeling, two option is there. Yesterday we have seen that if your Cartesian form, Cartesian grid is there, so labeling will be done from left to right, labeling will be done from left to right as A, B, C. Alphabetical labeling is going to be followed by the software in X direction. In Y direction, what numbering is going to be followed by the software? Numbering. Got it? So remember this thing. But in case of cylindrical format, the labeling, it is going to be done from the center to the outside, like A, B, C, D, E, F, like this. Labeling, it is going to be done from the center to outer side. Let me show you. See, first grid level labeling direction away from the center. If you want to make change toward the center, that will also be possible. What change will be there? It will be A, it will be B, C. Toward the center labeling is there, toward the center. Another option is what? Away from the center. So it's just a labeling option, nothing else. Now next is what? In tangential direction, first grid label will be 1 and labeling is going to be done in the clockwise direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that up to 21. Got it? Now next is what? In the clockwise direction, and if you want to make the change, you can make it a counterclockwise and counterclockwise. Got it? So this is what actually the labeling, this is what actually the labeling of the grid lines, grids of cylindrical format. What next you need to do, just go back and see global X, global Y and rotation about the Z. Where you want to put your grids? Suppose if you are taking this 0, 0, 0, so whatever you are going to form the grid line, that is going to be generated here, like this, or like this, sorry. The origin of your drawing, origin of your grid will be at the origin of this axis system. Okay, so that will be global X, global Y. And rotation. What rotation you want? You want to keep it, it is normal situation, or you want, if you want any inclination, according to that, you have to put that this degree. Suppose 30 degree, 45 degree, 120 degree, whatever you want, that you can put rotation about the global axis. So this is what you have to put the values. Now grid dimensions. Number of grid lines in radial direction. How many number of grids? As I told you, we have to consider only half part. So this is the one, this is the second, third, four, five, six. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six number of grid lines along the radial direction. Just change it from 4 to 6. 6 will be there. Number of grid lines in tangential direction. It is very important. How to count the number of grid lines in tangential direction? The simple formula is there. Total degree from left to right, total angle. So total angle is what? Can anyone tell me? Hello?
180.
Exactly. 180 divided by unit angle between the two tangential line. It is what? 9 degree.
9 degree.
Just change it, 9 in degree. Then plus 1. It will become what? 10. It is
21.
Yes, 21. 21 number of tangential lines will be there from first to end. From first to end, it will be 21. Just go back to it as. The formula is actually given here. Remember. Okay. Just go back to it as. And see how many it will be. 21. Spacing of grids in radial direction. In radial direction, what is the spacing between the two grids? So 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, like that. So just change it to 4. And spacing of grids in tangential direction, so it will be what? In tangential direction, spacing is what? By the angle, it is 9 degree. It is 9 degree. Unit angle is what? Is 9 degree. Change it to 9. Now just say simply OK. This is all done. Now simply say OK. Hello, is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
So how correctly we have created the cylindrical grid line in the ATAP software. Now, if you want to make change any in this existing grid, what you need to do? Go to edit grid system and go to second one. This is the first one, this is the second one. Go to second one, just click over modify and show grid system. Once you click over the modify and show grid system, so this kind of representation will be there. I want to change it, the color to the, some dark color, dark, and labeling will be bubble size, let it be as it is. Now I want to rotate this by the 30 degree. So rotation will be what? 30 degree. Just say okay.
Yes, sir. All the grid lines are rotated by 30 degree.
Yes. In the 3D view, you can see. Is it a 3D view? You can move this, rotate this as per your requirement. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So that is the way how you can create the cylindrical grids in the ETAP software. I hope it's all clear. It's clear to all of you. Now next, go to file, go to new model, say no. Now next grid system is a grid option, grid format is what we have to draw. We have to create this kind of grid. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, Fan, how we can create this grid line? Suppose this kind of architecture plan is there. A architecture plan is there, and over that, if you are working, you are getting this kind of center line plan, and that center
we
line
will use
plan,
two grid system.
Sorry,
in the as we created in that in before that only one grid system. Now we will create two, one for the semicircle and one second for the this component, sir, for the square. Sorry, rectangle.
You all are agreed? Yes, see. Actually, these lines are consisting of two grid system, like one is Cartesian, second one is the cylindrical. For the half circle that you are looking, we are able to form this grid line using the cylindrical format. Okay, cylindrical grid system, and this is the normal Cartesian grid system. The Cartesian one, this is the cylindrical one. Just go back to ETAP and go to use built-in setting with. Okay, this is all done. Metric SI, Indian, IS-800/2000, IS-456/2000, now say simply OK. Once you click over the OK, go back, and this is what, can anyone tell me, it is uniform one or non-uniform one?
Non-uniform.
First, we are going to complete this Cartesian one. Clear this all?
Yes.
In X direction, how many number of grids are there? These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Eight number of grid lines are there in X direction. Just go back and put it as 8 numbers in X direction. Go back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 numbers in Y direction, go back, put 4 numbers in Y direction, spacing, any typical spacing is there, any common spacing is there, 5.9, 10.2, 9.6, like that, so nothing is there, let it be, in Y direction, nothing similar spacing is there, uniform spacing is there, so let it be, whatever, okay, now next, go to custom grid. It is needed to work with the custom or not? Fast.
Yes, sir. It is needed to custom grid.
Yes. Needed. Then go with the display grid data as spacing. Check this option. Now come down and see what is the space or distance between. What is the distance between G and H? G and H in respect of G, 5.9. So it will be what? 5.9. Next, what it will be? 10.2. Change it to 10.2. What next will be there? 9.6, 5.3. 9.6, 5.3, 6.2. 9.1, 3.9. 9.1. 3.9. Okay. Now next, in y direction, how much it is? 4.9, 5.8. 4.9.
5.8.
5.8. Next. 4.6. Okay. Choose some dark color. Okay. Just say okay. And rest of all the things is okay. Now simply say okay. And we want the grid lines. So you have to choose this option. Don't do the mistake of clicking over the blank. You, if you want the grids, you need to click over these grids after giving all the basic definition here in plan. So go to grid online, grids only, check this one and say simply okay. Once you click over the okay, so this grid system, grid lines will be available. And this is the Cartesian one, you know very well. This is what, this is the Cartesian one. Now we have to add one more grid. This is the Cartesian one. We have to add one more grid system. So go to file, go to editor, go to edit story and grid system. See G1, one grid system is there. That is the Cartesian one. We have to add one more grid system. Let's say add a new grid system. Once you click over the add a new grid system, so the new grid you have to make as cylindrical one. So check this one, cylindrical one. Check this one as cylindrical one and R grid labeling. Okay, so labeling will be by default. We are not going to make any change in the labeling of the cylindrical grids. Now, position, global axis, global x-axis, global y-axis, and its rotation. So, how to find the location? This grid, this semicircle is actually positioned away from the origin. Suppose we are going to consider this at origin, 0, 0. Suppose we are going to create it. This is a 0, 0, 0. So from this, what is the distance of this point, this center point, that you need to find out. So the height, y direction is very simple. From this 4.9 plus 5.8 plus 4.6, that totally will give you y dimension, ordinate y. We have to find out this ordinate x comma y. So y is actually what? 4.9 plus 4.9, 5.8, and 4.6. 4.9, 5.8, 4.6. How much it is? Can one tell me? 15.3. It is what actually? X, Y is equal to X, Y. 15.3.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Now, next, let me check it once. Otherwise, there is a possibility of error. 5.8 plus 4.6. Okay, 15.3. What about the y? Sorry, x.
31.
Sorry, how?
Sir, by 5.9 plus 10.2 plus 9.6 plus 5.3.
Okay, see, just add this value. 5.9. Let me show you how to do this. 5.9 plus 10.2 plus 9.6 plus 5.3 plus 6.2 plus 9.1 plus 3.9. Just say equal.
Minus 10.
Wait. This is what? 50.2. Overall dimension, overall distance between this start end point and start point is what? 50.2 meter is there. Now, this is what? 2 meter. So, from end to this point, total distance is what? 10 meter. So, just take the 50.2 minus 10. How much it is going to become?
49.8.
Sorry?
Yeah, 40.2.
So this is what x dimension, x ordinate. This is what 40.2. So x is what 40.2, y is what 15.3. Remember, So just go back to eta epsilon. And x is what? 40.2. Y is what?
15.3.
So this value, we don't want any rotation, normal. Then number of grids, grid lines in radial direction. How many number of grids are there in radial direction? This will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is 6. So just go back and put it as 6 in radial direction. In tangential direction, how many? Let me show you. So the angle is actually not given here, but it is 18 degree. It is actually what? 18 degree. So total angle is what? 180 divided by unit angle is what? 18 degree 18 plus 1. How much it will be? It will be 11. 11 number of grids in tangential direction will be there. So change it to what? 11. Just clear these all. Spacing of the grids in radial direction. Spacing of the grids in radial direction. So as you can see, spacing of grids in radial direction is 2 meter. Okay, 2 meter. And in tangential direction, it is 18 degree. Okay, remember. So go back. And it is what? In radial direction it is 2 meter. And in tangential direction, it is what? It is 18 degree. Now it is done. Now say simply okay. Then see simply okay. Hello. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So this is the way how you can form the different two grids of totally different. One is your Cartesian one, another one is your cylindrical one. So this is the way. Suppose if you want to make the change of color of this cylindrical grid, so just go to edit, story and grid system, go to second one, go to modify and change the color to the red one. Just say simply okay. Now say okay. Is that clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, so this is the way how you can create the grid lines in the ETABS software. This is what two methods we have covered. First one is offset point method. Second one is what? ETABS quick template method. And third one we are going to see as export and import method. Export and import method. So see, suppose your architectural drawing is like this. Let me show you. Suppose your architectural drawing is like this. Yeah, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Suppose this kind of architectural drawing is there, and if you want to form the grid lines for this project, for this architectural drawing, and for this structure in the ETAF software, so it is very complicated. Why? Because see, very large number of grids you need to form. Very close grids will be there. Even plus the geometry is very complicated. So that's why it is very difficult to form the grid lines for this kind of structure, because it is not simple one. The geometry is not simple. Arrangement is simple, but the geometry is not simple. So for that case, the previous methods are very difficult. If you are going to follow, if you are saying that, okay, I will go through the offset point method. So can you imagine how many number of points you need to create there? Then how you will find the ordinates of each joints, each point? So is it possible? Hello?
No, sir.
No, it is not possible. Not at all. It is possible. Okay. So first option is not okay. Second option is quick template. So quick template is okay. But if you are going to practice with that, so that is complicated. Means very tedious job. Very confusing, and you will means not able to do this. Then what? Then the third point is come into the picture, that you can export the drawing from the CAD, export the center line drawing from the CAD, and that center line plan you can directly import in the ETAB software, so that your work will be easy. So that is the of use of the export and import option. Got it? So see, just go to click here. Yeah, is it visible? Suppose
yes,
this is a beam layout. What things will be there? First is what your architecture plan will be there. Over the architecture plan, you have to prepare the center line plan. Sorry, you have to prepare the beam layout or structural framing plan. If you are knowing the structural framing plan, if you are knowing the beam layout, so that's well and good. But if you are not knowing what does it by the structural framing plan or beam layout, okay, don't worry. We will discuss it all in detail later. But right now, just try to understand your beam layout will consist of beams, columns, slabs, their positions, their label. Okay. So after having the beam layout or structural framing plan, we have to prepare the center line by taking the center of the beams or center of the column. Then finally, we are having this kind of center line plan. This kind of center line plan we are having. So as you can see, okay, it is okay. It's a normal. You can go with the it has quick template option also for forming the grids. And if you want, if you are feeling that it is complicated, then you can go with the export and import option also. It's your choice sometimes. So it is simple also and is complicated also. That is your choice. So I'm going to consider it a complicated one. I'm not interested to form the grids in the ETAP software itself by the ETAP's quick template option. I want to export this center line from here and I want to import it in ETAP software. So how to do this? That's very important. So first thing is what? First, make sure that in which layer this, try to keep these all lines in one layer. Don't do the mistake. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Make sure that all the lines that you want to export, okay, that should be in one layer. So if I'm selecting this line, so it is center line layer. Okay. Overall, if I'm selecting, so overall drawing is in center line layer. Remember that line. Now select these all from left to right. Let select all this drawing completely. And then press Ctrl C. Just press Ctrl C. Okay. One more thing is that, can anyone tell me what is the file type of the, what is the saved file type of the AutoCAD?
DWG.
DWG.
Yukta.
DWG.
DWG. Okay. You all are knowing. Okay. It is DWG. So if you want to import the CAD drawing in the ETAP software, so you need to have the DXF file. Hello?
Yes, sir.
You need to have the DXF file. So for that, what we are going to do, first control, copy this all, select this all, just press Ctrl C. So this drawing and these elements on this picture will be copied. Now just come outside and open the new CAD. Nothing will be there. It will be blank. Now simply say control. Just say control V. So now your drawing is present here. But very important point I would like to say. We have to take this drawing at the origin. We have to take this drawing at the origin. So what, after having this drawing here, just press 0, 0. Now say enter. So your drawing will come to the origin. Your base point, start point will come to the origin. What is what its use and what how it will help for your work, we will see it later. Now, after having this, go to save this file, save as, in DXF format, other formats, and go to desktop, go to I would like to save this file 001 DXF hello and change the label as change the AutoCAD 2000. Sorry, change, don't write the DXF 001 and change it to from DWG to what DXF format. DXF format. Now save this file. Hello, is it visible?
Yes, you all are visible? Yes, sir.
Now close this file. It will ask to save the file, save the drawing in DWG format also. So we are not interested to save this. Say no. Now go back to itabs, go to file, go to new model, say no. Then you have to decide the unit system. So for you, for deciding the unit system, what you need to do, you need to check the dimension, distance. This is what distance between this point is what 5.97. It is metric system or feet or inches. What is this?
Metric.
So just go back to itabs, change it to metric one. Rest of all the things will be as it is. Now simply say okay. Once you click over the okay, what actually we don't want any grid. We don't want any grid. Okay. We want blank. We want actually blank. We want to import the drawing from the CAD. We want to import the drawing. So right now we don't need to put anything. Just say blank. We want blank space. Say okay. Now see, go to file. After getting into the software, we are having two views. That is the plan view and 3D view. One more thing. How many stories are there? See, go to plan. See, base is there. Story 1 is there. Story 2 is there. Story 3 is there. Story 4 is there. So total 4 stories are there. 4 levels are there. What? 4 levels are there. Just say okay. Now go to file. Go to import. Go to import. Go to DXF file of floor plan. DXF.DXF file of floor plan. Click over this option. Once you click over that option, it will ask about the location where your DXF file is saved. So this is a 001. Check this one and say open. Now this is asking what beam is there in your drawing, column is there or not in your drawing, floor is there or not, opening is there or not. So here we just want to have only the lines. So we are going to take it as a reference of beam. Lines is nothing but we are going to consider as beam. So what layer was, hello, what layer was, have you remember this line layers? What it was?
Center line.
Center line. Okay. So that we have to choose here. Don't do the mistake. Beams will be the what? Center line. Check this one. And we don't want to have the column, floor, openings. We are not interested in this. So let it be as it is. Unchecked. DXF file unit. DXF file unit. So it is in meter. Hello. Very important. Sometimes what you will do, you are drawing it in feet and inches and you are considering here as meter. Sometimes you are drawing it is in mm and you are going to put here in meter. So if it is in mm, you have to put the mm. If it is in meter, you have to put it in meter. Got it? So don't do the mistake. Okay, what property you want to assign? Suppose all the lines is going to be converted into beams. All the lines it is going to be converted into beams. And what property you want to assign for that beams? So the properties of the section will be available here. So let it be concrete beam. For the column, if you are going to take the column also, so what property you want to assign for the column, that will be available. If the slab you want to import from the CAD to ETABS, so what property you want to import, that will be available here. Okay, go to story and story 1. Where you want to import the drawing? Either on story 1, story 2, story 3, story 4, what? Where you want to import? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Base.
Okay. We want to import it at story first. Check this one, story first. And this is a global up direction, vertical direction is Z. Okay. Now simply say okay. I want to import on story first, remember. So simply okay. It is asking to save the model. It is asking to save the model. Okay. Save the work. Save this file. In the 3D view, it is in view. In the 3D view, wow. It is in view. But in plan view, it is not in view. Can anyone tell me why? Because we are at the story 4. We are at the story 4. And where we have imported the file?
Story 1.
Exactly, story 1. So go to plan and come to the story 1 and say simply OK.
Apply,
exactly. Now come to this level. So yeah, this is what. Okay, so this is the way how you can export the drawing from CAD and how you can import the drawing in the ETAB software. And what important things you need to take care as what units of your basic drawing, like CAD drawing, and the file format while saving it should be DXF one. Okay, and see, after importing in the software, what care you need to take? Hello. This, what is the dimension? 5.97. So make sure that this is properly imported or not. It is correctly imported or not. So just right click over this and I want to see whether it is right or wrong. So go to draw dimension line. Draw dimension lines and close this. This is the first point and this is the next point. It is a 5.9735. So it is right or wrong?
Approximately equal to the same dimension.
Approximately not. It is exactly 5.97 and it is also 5.97. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So that you also need to make sure that whether the drawing is imported correctly or not. Because see, I told you many times, if your model is wrong, see, your grid is wrong, then your model will be wrong. If your model is wrong, your analysis will be wrong. Analysis is wrong, design wrong, scheduling wrong, detailing wrong, everything will be what? Hello? Everything will be wrong. So very first step, the initial stages steps should be very correct. Okay. So this is all how you can export the drawing from the CAD and how you can import the drawing in the ETAB software. It's all okay. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
So just keep in mind. And one more thing. Why we have taken this center line at the origin 00 while saving? Because see, if you are taking, so your drawing will not be at the origin. Your drawing will be here. Your drawing will be here, somewhere here. And your origin will be here. So in that situation, what problem you will face? Every time you have to zoom it. You have to correct it to your view. Then when you move up, then you are coming back. Then again you need to set. So every time you need to do this. Hello?
Yes, sir.
That will be the problem. Okay. So this is all about how you can export the drawing, how you can import the drawing. If you have any doubt and question, you can ask.
Can you please explain one time more how to draw a center line in AutoCAD?
Roughly. How to?
Draw center line in AutoCAD.
Center line plan.
How to draw?
Sorry?
कैसे AutoCAD में center line plan draw किया जाता है?
वो आएगा सर आगे topic.
ओके फाइन नो
वो चीजें आगे टॉपिक हम लोग सब पूरा बहुत ब्रीफ में सारी चीजें देखेंगे. ओके
ओके फाइन फाइन
ये तो अभी हम लोग लर्न करना है. ये तो हम लोग ग्रिड देख रहे हैं. व्हाट इज हाउ यू कैन फॉर्म द ग्रिड ऑप्शंस, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट ऑप्शन बेसिक्स. अभी इसमें आगे हम लोग डीप में जाएंगे इसके अंदर सारी चीजें. ओके
यस 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 नाउ क्लियर.
अभी ओके रिमेम्बर फ्रॉम दिस सेकंड सेशन टू टिल द 12 और 13 सेशन ऑल द बेसिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर यू शुड बी फैमिलियर विद द सॉफ्टवेयर फर्स्ट वेरी वेरी बेसिक एंड वेरी मीन्स एडवांस थिंग्स वी हैव टू सी इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ सेटिंग्स इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ कमांड्स लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स वी हैव टू लर्न ओके डू यू नो अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट द ट्रस्ट हेलो
Yeah, it's a structure which carry your loads on joint and all the joints will be considered as a pin joint.
So for the analyzing of the truss, okay, can anyone tell me what are the different assumptions you might be learning in your bachelor's, your diploma or your master's? Okay, what are the assumptions of analyzing the truss? What are the different assumptions?
External loads acting on a joint only. All joints are pin joint or rigid one. And no member force will be there. No shear force, no bending moment, only axial force will be there.
Okay.
No rotational moment of the joint. It will be translate only either X or Y direction. If we are considering 3D, it will be translated in X, Y, Z, all three directions.
Yes, yes. Exactly. See, suppose truss is there like this. Okay. So what assumptions are there? All members are connected at their ends only. All the members, these are the individual members. This is the first, this is the individual, this one is the individual, this one is the individual. All members are individual, separate, and they are connected at their ends only. By the hinge connection. So that this member is going to carry only the axial forces, either tension or compression. And the loading will be only at this joint. There will be no loading at the intermediate, at the mid of any member or anywhere in between their ends. The loading will always at the joints. So these are some basic assumptions for the analyzing of the truss element, truss structure. So this is very important to understand for our further discussion, for our further action. Okay, just keep in mind. So go back. The next exercise is what? We have to discuss some basic elements like beams and like your truss element. Structure. Okay, so through this exercise we have to learn so many things. The objective is what? We have to learn so many things. Actually, we are going to see the validation of the software, whether your software is giving the correct output or not, correct result or not. If you are giving the input right, so we should get the output right. If you are giving the input wrong, so we will get output wrong. So we are going to validate the software whether it is giving the right result or not. And along with this exercise, we have to learn so many things. Like we have to understand the axis systems, different types of the axis. We have to learn the release concept. We have to learn the loading assignments. We have to learn the how you can see the stresses in the elements, like axial force, moment, shear force, like that. How you can see the reaction. So many things we have to learn in this exercise. The first exercise is now over. In the first exercise, what we have learned? How to form the grid lines. How to form the grid lines in the ETAP software by the different methods. Now the second exercise is what? Validation of the software. Hello?
Yes, clear.
Second is what? Validation of? Hello?
Yes, clear.
Validation of the software. Got it. So first of all, try to understand what does mean by the axis. What are the different axis systems? Can anyone tell me what are the different types of the axis systems? Fast. Do you have any idea? Anyone? Fast. Don't take much time. Do you have any idea about the axis systems?
In ETAPs, we have global system. X, Y, Z.
Global system. Okay. What does mean by the global system?
we will consider all the forces in global direction, not in local direction. Means globally consider karenge.
Sorry?
Globally, all the forces or members from globally consider karenge. Local direction mein consider nahi kare. For an example, if some member is in X direction, but if its inclination in X direction, but it may be possible a member of the X direction will be different and global X direction will be different. So we will consider global wala X direction consider karenge.
Okay. Partly you are correct. Okay. Now just try to understand. See. Okay, what does mean by the global axis? What done by the local axis? Okay, three types of the axis systems will be there. One is your global axis system, one is your local axis system, and third one is the natural axis system. Global, local, and natural. Just try to understand what does mean by the global axis. What does mean by the global axis system? So the global axis system is that system which represent your entire model for your entire structure. The axis system which represent your entire structure is nothing but the global axis. Is nothing but the what? Global axis. What does it mean by the global? See, this is what, if you are talking about this model, so only one element is not there. Only one element is not there. Okay, this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 number of elements are there. Suppose this is the column, this is the beam. If you are considering the slab, so slab is also there over this. So number of elements are there. And this axis system, if is representing this entire model, this entire structure in once, globally. It is going to represent it globally. So all the elements which is running in this direction, we are going to call it as, this is along the x direction. All the elements which is running in this direction, okay, in this direction, it is what? Along the y direction. All the elements which is running in this direction, we are going to call it as along the z direction. Hello?
Yes, clear.
Okay, so see, this is what solid body. This is what actually the solid body. It is having the three dimension in x, in y, and in z. But we are going to count it by the element. We are going to call it by the element. We are not going to consider it totally solid. If totally solid is there, so this direction is x, you know very well, this direction is y, this direction is z. But we are considering here the elements. So this element is in x, this element in y, and this element, all the elements, whatever the elements are there, which is in this direction, all that elements we are going to call it as along the z. All the elements which is in this direction, we are going to call it along the x. All the dimensions, all the elements we are in this direction, we are going to call it as y. Is that clear? Hello?
Yes.
That's sir.
Why we
yes,
are
sir.
Going to call it as global axis.
We have to consider global directions. Means
global direction.
Pura system ka direction consider.
Yes. Pura system ko represent kar rahe. Okay. The axis system which is representing your entire structure. Your entire structure, we are going to call it as global axis. Now, come to the next one, local axis. What does it mean by the local axis? Okay, global axis will also be there to represent your entire model. But, come to the next point, if you are talking about any particular element like beam, if I am going to consider beam. So, beam is also a solid element or not? It is having its three dimension, length, width and depth. Hello?
Yes.
Beam is also a solid element. It is also having three dimensions like width, depth, and height. Agreed or not?
Yes, sir. I agree.
Yeah. So the beam will have its own axis system. Beam will have its own axis system like along the length. Suppose it will be XX. Along the width, it will be what? YY. Along the depth, it will be what? ZZ. Got it? X, X, Y, Y, Z, Z, along the X, along the Y, Y, along the Z. So this is what? Its own axis, element axis, its own axis. Come to the next, in column. Column is also having its own axis. It is also a solid body, solid element. It is having its width, depth, and height. So see, what its own axis. Height is represented by the 1-1, width is represented by the 2-2, depth is represented by the 3-3. If you are talking about the slab, slab is also a solid element. Slab is also a solid element. It is having its length, width, depth. So it is all individual elements having its own axis system, and that own axis system we are going to call it as natural axis. Hello.
Yes, clear.
It's clear?
Yes.
It's all clear or not?
Yes.
Come to the next level. See, if you are talking about the particular beam, so the beam is actually made up of by the accumulation of number of solid particles. Hello.
Yes, sir.
That is formed of a number of solid particles, and that solid particle will also having its width, length, and depth. If you are talking any solid particle, so it's a very minor width, very minor depth, very minor height will be there or not? These are solid particle. If you are considering any cube, so this cube will also be having its depth, length, height. Small will be there, no, because this beam is made up of small solid particles. And that small solid particles will have its own axis system. And that axis system we are going to call it as natural axis. Hello. Understood
yes,
or not?
Yes, sir.
It's all clear?
Yes, sir, clear.
So if you look at the ETAP software, just tell me. It is what? Is the global axis or
global
local axis or natural axis?
Global axis.
It is what? It is actually the global axis. Remember, it is the global axis. These beams. Now tell me, this is what?
Local axis.
It is actually the local axis. Okay, this is the global axis, and this one is the
local axis.
Local axis, and in ETAP software is not representing the natural axis. Okay, so that is for your understanding and for your knowledge only. Here, the two main axis system we have to look. One is global axis, another one is the local axis. It's all clear. We will talk about this later in detail. So this is global and this is what? It is the local. It's all understood or not?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, clear.
Clear? We will come to this topic later at the time of the beam analysis. Okay. So the first topic is now over. Understanding the axis consideration in respect of ETAP software, like natural axis, local axis, global axis. Got it. Now, see. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, visible.
So we have to model this truss. We have to model this truss in the ETAP software, and actually the assignment of the loadings are actually given here. All the geometry consideration is actually given here, and the manual result output is also present here. So we have to validate this with the software, whether your software is giving the correct result or not, whether your result matching with the ETAP software or not. This is correct. The result that we are having with the manual calculation is right, but we have to check with the software. So go to file, go to new model, say no. First of all, you have to decide the unit. Can anyone tell me what is the unit? Hello?
Metric.
So just go back and change it to what? Metric. So it will be metric SI. Let it be, not say simply okay. Now, see. Can anyone tell me, it is the plan view or elevation view? First.
elevation view.
Sana, do you have any idea?
It is a software.
Consider in plan, this is x axis. In plan, this is the y axis, and over the height, z axis. Remember, in 3D view, I would like to show you. This is the x one, this is the y one, and this is the z. So this drawing is either in zx plane or zy plane. It is not in xy plane. Okay, it is in either zy plane or zx plane, because elevation inclusion will be there, because it is along the height. So okay, we are going to consider it is in x and z plane. This drawing is present. Now tell me, how many grids we have to take in plan first? Actually, it is in elevation, but we have to define the grid lines in plan. So can anyone tell me how many grids in x direction first?
Seven.
How seven?
One, sir.
One. Okay. Anyone else first?
Seven.
How you are counting seven? Simple. See,
sir,
this is one.
Sir, three.
No, wrong. Let me show. In plan, how many will be there? This is the one, this will be the two, this is over the height, Sana.
Yes, sir.
This is over the height. Don't consider this one. That's why I'm asking. This is the in plan we are looking. If you look from the top, so what? These points will be as a line. And this is actually over the height. Don't consider this. This is over the height. Got it? Very simple. So see, this is what? This is the first one, this is the second one, this is the third one, and this is the fourth one. Now tell me, how many grids will be in x direction? Hello?
Four, sir.
Okay. So along with the validation of this software and checking this result, we have to learn so many things. So you will be, means you are going to work on next level. Okay. Just go back to ETABS, and number of grid lines in x direction will be four. Number of grid lines in y direction. Can anyone tell me? In
three,
y direction.
Three, zero, zero.
That, yes,
zero.
As we have decided that our drawing, our model or our structure is in x. This is the x and this is the z. XZ plane and this is the y direction in plan. So can you tell me in y direction, is there any grid? Hello?
Zero. No grid.
Zero. But not zero. Either if you are considering, this drawing is actually like this. Okay, so this line, I can consider the first line. I can consider this first line in the y direction. Hello, this is also
minimum
in y.
Grid line consider karna padega. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Am I right or wrong? Hello. Because your ETABS will not understand zero. It is not going to consider zero. So you have to put one. Hello?
Yes.
Here, just go back to ETABS and number of grid lines in y direction, you have to put as one. Spacing of grids in x direction. What spacing is there? So yeah, uniform spacing is there. 4, 4, 4. Just go back and put it as, close this. Put it as 4. Spacing in x direction, 4. In y direction, nothing is there, but still we are going to put one. Let it be. Now let me know, is there any need to work with the custom first?
Sorry, sir. We are going to per meter in y direction.
Actually, it is not going to accept zero value. See,
I accept. We are going to assume per meter in y direction. Okay. Base will be 1 meter per meter. Ke liye consider kiya wahi na.
Yes. Now, just give me an answer. It is needed to work with the custom. Hello?
Yes, required in Z direction.
No, what? You don't need to put any Z direction. Z direction, we have to work with this height. Story information will be there. Over the height, we have to put the value. So this is what, okay, over the height. So it has what it will do. It has what it will do. It will create the levels. So base level will be by default anytime. Anytime your ETAS will create the base level. And a base level means what? Foundation level. Base level is what? Actually the foundation level. This is what? Actually the foundation level. And this will be the ground level. Suppose this is the ground level. This is your first floor level. This is your second floor level, like that. So this is the foundation level will be given by the ETAS software by default. This will be the ground level. This is the first and second. Got it. So basically what we have to do, this ETAPS has given this level by default base. Base will be there. Now this is the first level, this will be the second level. So how many levels will be there totally? Hello?
Two. Three levels
will be there. This will be the base. This will be the base. This will be the first, this will be the second. But while you have to put the value here, how many levels you have to put? You have to put only two. Because base will be by default. Base will be there anyhow. So additional two you have to put. Number of story. Typical story height. The height that is going to be repeated. The height that is going to be repeated, that you have to put here. Typical story height. What does mean by the typical story height? Okay, just try to understand. Suppose a building is there like this. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Very simple. This is the what I told you. This is the foundation level. So it has will by default give the foundation level as base level. Okay, base level. Now, this is your what? This is what actually your you can say ground level. It is what actually the ground level. This is your first floor level. This will be the second one. This will be the third one. This will be the fourth one. Okay. So suppose the height of This is what ground, this is what first, this is what second, this is what third, and this is what the fourth. It is G plus 4 building. It is G plus 4 building. Remember, it is G plus 4 building. And the height, this is the thickness of the slab, this is the thickness of the level, this is the thickness of the level, this is the thickness of the level, and this is what the thickness of the level, and this is what thickness of the level. Can anyone tell me, if I am talking about this third floor, hello, you all are with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If it is the third floor, can you tell me, for the third floor, which one is the slab? For the third floor, which one is slab? Either this one or this upper one?
Upper one, sir.
Upper one, okay, very good. Anyone else?
थर्ड फ्लोर का वो रूफ होगा थर्ड फ्लोर जो है सर तो वो उसी लेवल पे है ना
एनीवन एल्स ओके जावी सर जावी जी नेक्स्ट सना कैन यू टेल मी इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस थर्ड फ्लोर सो व्हिच वन इज द स्लैब आइदर दिस वन लोअर वन और अपर वन
लोअर वन
Third top will be slab.
Okay. Fast. All you have to give the answer fast.
Third top.
Top. Arun?
Up one, sir. Top one.
Okay. So, okay. 50% is correct. 50% is wrong. Okay. Actually, what? Lower one is the slab. Is actually the slab. Okay. This is the slab of the third floor. This is the slab of the third floor, and this one is the roof of the third floor.
Yes, sir.
This is one the roof of the third floor. This is the ground slab is what? This one. First floor slab is this one. Second floor slab is this one. Third floor slab is this one. Fourth floor slab is this one. एंड फोर्थ फ्लोर रूफ इज दिस वन, थर्ड फ्लोर रूफ इज दिस वन, सेकंड फ्लोर रूफ इज दिस वन, फर्स्ट फ्लोर रूफ इज दिस वन, ग्राउंड फ्लोर रूफ इज दिस वन. गॉट इट? सो दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. मेनी टाइम्स स्टूडेंट्स कंप्लीटेड देयर मास्टर्स एंड दे आर वर्किंग ऑल्सो, दे आर नॉट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट एंड दिस बेसिक थिंग इज नॉट क्लियर. हेलो. So it is very important to understand. Now next, it is the floor to floor height. The floor to floor height will be counted from top of the slab, from the top of the slab to the next top of the slab. And the distance between from the top of the first slab to the next top of the slab, we are going to call it as what? Floor to floor height. Floor to floor height, remember, from the base slab top to next level slab top, it will be considered as a floor to floor height. It will be considered as floor to floor height. Remember, floor to floor height. So simply what we need to do, floor to floor height. So we are talking about the level. We are going to discuss about the level. So base level, foundation level will be there anytime. Now practically, if you look, so the foundation will be there, above to the foundation ground will be there, and above to ground plinth will be there. Is it right? Ground will also be there, and plinth will also be there. In ETAP software, we are not going to create these two levels separately. So we are going to merge it, and we are directly taking the plinth level. Hello. We are directly going to take it directly at the plinth level. We are going to merge these two level and moving to the next level, plinth. So this one level will be there. And then suppose G plus 4 building is there. Then this will be the ground. This is the ground level, ground floor. Then this will be the first floor, first. Then it will be the second floor. And then it will be, okay, only second, so G plus 2 is there. Now, suppose if you want to put the number of stories in the ETAP software, suppose you have to put a number of stories here. So how you can decide how many levels are required finally? So very simple concept is what? Suppose G plus 2 building is there, add two more number. That much number of number of stories you have to put as 4. Hello. How you can decide? Because this first, second will always be there. First, second will always be there. Then plinth, additional plinth will be there, and second roof will be there. So this one and this two. This two will be additional. So G plus 2 plus 2. So it will become what? 4. Suppose G plus so 10 is there. G plus 10 is there. So what you will do? How many number of stories you are going to put first?
Please repeat kijiye na.
What?
Wo G plus 2 plus 2 wala repeat kijiye na.
Dekhiye, simple. What concept is there? Simply, this is your base foundation level. Don't count this. This is your plinth level. This is your first. This is your second, and this is your third, and okay, this is your third. This is the ground floor, this is the first floor, this is the second floor, and this one is the third floor. So what you need to do, simply, suppose G plus 3 building, ground plus 3, G plus 3 building is there. So one slab, second slab, third slab, as equal to number of stories. Slabs will be there as equal to number of story. So this is G plus 3 plus 2. Plus 2 you have to do for this plinth one and for this top one. For these two additionals will be there. So 3 plus 2, how much it will become? Hello?
5.
So you have to put the number as 5. Suppose G plus 6 building is there. Hello?
8.
It will be 8. Suppose G plus 9 is there. Hello?
11.
So that is what? Basic idea. Later on you can change it. If suppose overhead tank is also there, so one level will you have to add. बट फॉर योर बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम स्टूडेंट्स आर कंफ्यूज व्हाट वी हैव टू पुट हियर नंबर ऑफ स्टोरीज दे आर कंफ्यूज ओके
सर स्टोरी
सॉरी
सर स्टोरी किसको काउंट कर रहे हैं हम लोग वो एक बार बता दीजिए
स्टोरी काउंट्स द लेवल्स
स्लैब लेवल
स्लैब लेवल्स लेवल्स एंड लेवल्स ओके ओके डोंट वरी इफ यू आर नॉट गेटिंग
और सिंपल ऐसा भी कंसीडर कर सकते हैं ना कि जी प्लस थ्री है तो ग्राउंड फ्लोर से स्लैब आएगा ठीक है और उनको हम प्लिंथ में कंसीडर करें ग्राउंड फ्लोर से थर्ड फ्लोर तक जाना ही पड़ेगा यानी कि फोर स्टोरी और बिलो द ग्राउंड लेवल दैट इज अ फाउंडेशन लेवल दैट इज योर वन मोर स्टोरी दैट्स द रीजन फाइव जी प्लस थ्री यानी कि फोर स्टोरी और वन बिलो द ग्राउंड लेवल दैट्स अ
डोंट मेक इट इज कॉम्प्लिकेटेड ओके अदरवाइज यू कैन रैंडमली पुट इट What I am telling you just for this is a judgment. This is what for the judgment. Don't make it as a complicated. Very simple. Hello. See.
Yes,
what
yes.
G plus 5 is there. Suppose G plus 5 is there. Okay. G plus 5 plus G plus 5 building is there. So what I will put? I will put here as 7. Simply. Later on what you can do? Later on you can change it. We will, all these points will come later. Okay. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, clear.
Yeah. So here, basically, what I would like to express levels. So this is the base level, foundation level will be there. So don't consider this one. Consider this one and this one. So two level will be there. Is there any another level? Hello, needed?
No.
No. Typical story height. So typical story height means what? The height that is going to repeat. The height which is going to repeat. The height which is going to repeat, we are going to call it as typical. We are going to call it as typical. So, but here that case is not present. Okay, this height is different and this height is different. Both heights are different. So typical is not there. So let it be any random height. Let it be any random height. Let it be 3 meter. Bottom story height. Let it be 3 meter. What does mean the bottom story height? What does mean the bottom story height? So bottom story height will be considered by the software from the ground to the foundation top. If you are going to deal any structure from ground to foundation top, it is considered by the software as foundation or bottom story height. Below the ground to the top of the foundation, this is the bottom story height. Remember. So, but let it be. It will be, if you are confused here, it is not clear to you, then go to custom, just go to edit grid, edit story data. Go to edit story data. Yeah, here it is the base, 0. Story 1, at what height your story 1 is there? At what height? Hello? At what
or
height?
Sine 30.
Sorry?
Or sine 30. Or
exactly.
Sine 30.
This is what? Angle is what? 30 degree. So, 4 tan 30, not sin 30. Hello? We want to
yes,
calculate
yes, yes.
this height. So, how you can calculate? 4 times tan 30. Find out this. 4 times tan 30. Fast.
2.31.
Anything else beyond of this? Sorry, it's wrong. It should not be 4. This is half. Actually, it should be 2. Hello. Half part we are going to consider.
Yes, half. Yeah.
Yes. This is what. Actually, this kind of geometry is there. 2 meter. It is 2 meter. Angle is 30 degree. And this height we need to know. So, height will equal to 2 times tan 30. Find out this now.
1.14.
Anything else? 2 times. 10:30. 1.1547, is it right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
1.1547, okay, meter. And next height, this height, total height, how you can calculate? Same, these are 4 plus 2. 4 plus 2 will become 6. 4 plus 2 will become 6. And this height we have to calculate, angle is 30 degrees.
6, 10,
30. Yes, 6, 6, 10, 30 for the overall height. 10, 30. Find out this, how much?
3.4641.
This is the total height. So total height we don't want. We want this height, this difference height. We want this difference height. We are having this height as 1 point. See, two heights are there. Okay. We are having this height as 1.1547. 1.1547. And this total height is what? 3.4641. 3.4641 minus 1.1547. Calculate this. To get the difference height minus 1.1547. Find out this. 2.3094. Hello. Agreed? This is 2.3094 and this is 1.1547. Is that clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
You all are with me or not?
Yes, sir. We are with
you. Yes, clear. Hello. One more question.
Yes.
इन केस ऑफ द नॉर्मल बिल्डिंग जी प्लस फोर वाला हमने कौन सी देखा था, उसमें तो हमको हमारे पास पूरा सेक्शन व्यू रहता है, ये तो हम सामने से देख रहे हैं एलिवेशन व्यू है, दैट्स रीजन वी हैव थ्री लेयर, एक वन लेयर तो ईटीएफ ने बाय डिफॉल्ट ले लिया, इसलिए हम दो लेयर कंसीडर कर रहे हैं इन हाइट वाले पोर्शन में, सही है ना?
यस यस,
ओके,
दैट विल बी क्लियर. ओके, दैट विल बी क्लियर व्हेन वी कम टू द रियल प्रोजेक्ट विल बी क्लियर. ओके, डोंट वरी. नाउ सी, जस्ट गो बैक टू ईटीएफ. Put this value 1.1547. First story height is what? 1.1547. Next height is what? Individual height 2.3094. This is also done. Total height is going to become 3.4641. Is it right? Okay, this is the cumulative height. This is the base foundation level is at 00. Story 1, its own height above the ground. It is 1.1547. It's a cumulative height from the origin. So that is 1.1547. Next, individual height of this story 2 above the story 1, 2.3094. And the cumulative height addition is what? 3.4641. So this is all done. Later on, master story, similar story, these all are the advanced points and concept. We will discuss it later. So, this is you can change the label also. Just first, you can change it to second like this. First and second, now say simply OK. Now, just go to story data is now OK. Everything is now OK. Just go to grids, click over the grids, say simply OK. Now the grids in plan view of the grids now available. This is what plan view. So only one grid is there as we have put, as we have given as a one grid in y direction or in x direction. In both of the direction one grid is there. Your drawing is in elevation. Your levels are along the elevation. So that's why one value is there, one label is there. So we have to walk in elevation. We have to walk in elevation along the grid first. We have to walk in elevation along the grid first. So just go back to ETAFs. Sorry, go to elevation and along the grid first. I want to see the elevation along the grid first. Check this one, say apply. Now it is the elevation view. And elevation, in elevation view, you will be able to see the labels of the level. Base, फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड. हेलो यू आर विद मी?
यस क्लियर.
ओके दिस इज द एलिवेशन व्यू. नाउ नेक्स्ट थिंग इज व्हाट वी नीड टू डू. वी एक्चुअली हैव टू मॉडल द एलिमेंट, मॉडल द दिस ट्रस. वी एक्चुअली हैव टू मॉडल दिस ट्रस. सो जस्ट टेक दिस फ्रेम. दिस व्हाट. ओके इन ETAP सॉफ्टवेयर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स आर देयर. In ETAP software, different types of the elements are there. One is your frame element. Frame element. And second one is what? Shell element. Hello? Shell. Shell element. Frame element and shell element. All your beams, columns, links, spindle. Okay, all these are included in the frame element. Frame element means what? We are going to call it as line element. Hello?
Yes, sir.
We are going to call it as line element. Means their lengths are, their lengths along the longitudinal directions are very large in comparison of its other two dimension. Like suppose, try to understand if you are talking about the column. So suppose this is the column, okay, and this is the height of the column. Suppose 4 meter height of the column is there. So height of column is 4000 mm and width is what? 230 mm only, and depth is also only 500 mm, like this. So in comparison of its longitudinal direction, longitudinal axis, longitudinal span, the width and depth is less. So we are going to call it as line element, and ETAP is calling to this as frame element. Hello. The same case for the beam also. Beam is having the small section size as width and depth, and length is large. Suppose 5 meter, 10 meter, like this beam. Hello, you all are agreed or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's why ETAP is considering the frame element. Like ETAP is considering the frame element and shell element. Now shell element will include what? Your slabs. Slabs, shear walls, okay, this all included in the shell element, because this type of elements having the large in-plane dimension, like length LX and LY. Slab is having the more dimension and very small depth. So we are going to consider it as area element. We are going to consider it as what? Area element. And this is what frame element means, what? Line element. Understood? Hello?
Sir,
yes.
What about staircase?
Sorry?
What about staircase, sir? Is it in frame or shell?
Shell. It is not frame. It is a shell. Okay? Shell or means, yes, shell element. That is area element. What is this? It is also a slab. But it is inclined slab. Your staircase is what? It is nothing but the slab, and it is what? Inclined slab only. Faizan, understood?
Yes, sir, got it.
Okay, coming back. So basically what? We have to model the element, model the member. So how to model? So just go back to frame, this frame. Draw beams, column, braces, all the line elements, frame. So this is what? This select object. When you click here, so see, you are free to do anything. Okay. This is what? Reshape object. Reshape option. We will discuss about this later. See, after this validation exercise, we have to go to the next exercise about the commands of the software. So, whatever the things you are understanding here, okay, don't worry. In the next section, we are going to cover all the commands. So, very brief and very interesting discussion will be there. Right now, what you are getting, just understand that. So, this is what the object point, this is the reshape option, this is the line element. If you want to draw frame element, line element, or beam and column braces, you have to go with this option. Click over this. A new dialog box will open up, and this will ask some basic details. I am again not going to discuss this in detail, okay, because I will take all these points in detail later. Right now, close this. But your command is now active. When you click here, now close this, now your command is active. You can model it. You can model the element member. So this is what, let me show you. The truss is there. As I told you, at all the joints, the member is going to be break. This is an individual member. 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 All members are individual. It will not be like this. This member will be from this point to this point, from start to end. Continuity is there. So put one member from one to from this end to this end. It is not like that. It is going to break. It is going to what? Break. So this is an individual. This is an individual. This one is the individual. This one is the individual. This one is the individual. Individual, this one individual. All these ones are individual members. Got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
These got all it, are sir. Individual members. Got it? Now, simply, go back to ETFs. So take the frame, close this. This is the first point. This is the point. Unless and until you are not getting the point, unless until you are not getting the point, this red sign or this label like the grid point C1, intersection of grid C and intersection of grid 1. So this is the point of intersection of grid 1 and grid C. And this is at what level? At the base level. All the things, unless and until you are not getting this point, don't click over that. Otherwise, this will lead the error in your modeling. Remember. So what I'm going to do? Just click over this first point. This is the first point. And come to the midpoint. Actually, it is going to break at the intermediate level. But I am going to model it continuously. But see, I want to have the midpoint of these two grids, B and C. Is it possible for me to find out the midpoint? Hello?
Yes, possible. How? There will be a function between two to create a mid joint in between two joint. It may be aisa kuch function hai.
No. Just
right click karke milega. Right.
Is it possible for me to get this right now?
Directly
no.
Not possible.
It is very difficult to get the center point. Center where it is, I am not knowing. So okay, right click to temporary off the command. See. If you want to off the continuity, this continuity which is there, and if you want to temporary off the command, right click on your mouse. The command is active, but it's temporary. It is not in action. It is not in action. Command is active. Remember, command is active, but it is not in action. Okay. And if you want to off this command, just click here, select object. Now the command is off. Nothing will be there. Okay. Now next. Actually, we need to look the center point. So right click on your window, go to snap option, and this option will help to make your modeling work more easy and more correct. So suppose if you want to get the center point, so line ends and midpoint, check this option. Hello? And midpoints, check this option. Now say apply, now close this. How you will get that? Just right click on the window, go to snap option, check this option, line ends and midpoint, check this, say apply, okay. Now again go to frame, beam, now close this. This is the first point and come to this level, midpoint, click over this. Is it okay? Hello? Coming back to this origin and click over this point. Now come to the continuity will be there. Take the help of this continuity and just click here. Freely move to the next point. Use this continuity. Click here. Freely move to the next point. Then click here. Okay. Now it's all done. I can't move anywhere. Just right click. Hello. So the command is not in action, but it is active. Command is active, but it is not in action. Hello, you all are with me?
Yes, clear.
Yes, okay.
Sir. Yes,
now,
sir.
Next, actually, from this point to this point, click here. One member is there. Right click, because I can't move. Undo. If you want to erase the last action what you have to do, go to editor, sorry, go to draw, yes, go to edit and undo. Yeah, last member will be deleted, last action will be deleted. Now this is the first point, freely move to this point and then click over that. Now the continuity is there and I can't move anywhere, no need. So right click on your mouse, so this continuity will be off, but the command will be active. Now same thing you have to do for this side, from this point to this point, click over that, right click. Now what next, let me check. Yeah, from this point to this point, now from here to here, it is all done. Let me check it. Is there any member who is missing? Fast. Sana. Hello.
No, sir.
All
no.
Clear.
It's all okay. It's all clear. Okay. All clear. All the members. Now, see. This is all done. One point have you seen? This is what support. Okay. I don't want off this command. Click here. Just see here. What? This support, this is what at the base level, this is actually the support. ETABS has assigning the support. We have assigned this support or ETABS has assigned this support? Tell me fast.
ETABS
has assigned this support. Why ETABS has assigned this support? Actually, we are not interested to assign this support right now. So, because actually we are working on the base level. As I told you, ETABS is considering the base level as what? As the foundation level. Hello? Okay. ETABS is considering the base level as what? Foundation level. Yeah. Is it visible or not?
Yes, sir.
At the base level, ETABS will by default assign the support. ETABS will by default assign the support as the hinge support. As the hinge support. There will be the three types of the support. One is your roller support. Another one is your hinge support. And another one is your fixed support. So three types of the supports will be there, roller, hinge and fixed. Three types of supports will be there, roller, hinge and fixed. Three types of the supports will be there. Got it? So these supports by default has given by the software. And if you look in our question, so on the left side it is the hinge support. Hello? On left side it is the hinge support. At B and C, is there any support? Hello?
No.
Only joint. So we have to remove this. Okay. One more thing we are going to learn. How you can select the joint. How you can make the selection. So if you are moving from left to right. If you are dragging from left to right. Whatever the things coming inside of this box. It is going to be selected. Whatever the things. Which is going to be come. Inside of this box. Completely, that will be in selection only. So only joints is coming inside. Suppose, okay, I am dragging from here to here. So can you tell me what things are coming inside of this box if you are dragging from left to right?
Joint for plus
four. Only the joint. Right. Only the top joint. So one joint is in selection. And where you can see this selection is actually present here. One joint is selected. One joint is selected. Clear this. Suppose I am dragging from left to right like this. So what things are coming inside of this box? See. Focus on this. Sorry. Focus on this. And this element. I am dragging from left to right. See. What things are completely coming inside of this box? One member. Hello. And two joint. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Yes, then I am going to left it. Now see, two joints, one frame. Two joints and one frame is in selection. Is it right or wrong? Because
yes,
these
sir.
Two things are coming inside of the box. So if you are dragging from left to right, whatever the things coming inside of the box will be selected, will be in selection. Always working with the ETABS software while modeling, you have to concentrate on left side. You have to concentrate here. What things is in selection? We will talk about this in detail later. and on right side this point. Got it? So basically what? Left, right to left. If you are dragging from right to left, so what selection, how the selection will be there? So whatever the things is going to be cut, whatever the things which is going to be cut by this box, plus whatever the things coming completely inside of this box, it is going to be selected. Hello? If you are dragging from right to left, whatever the things coming inside of this box, and whatever the things which is going to be cut by this box, intersected by this box, which is going to be selected, just say select. Hello? It's all understood? Hello?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Got it. Drag from left to right. See, all this member, and this member. All these members are going to be cut. Four members plus one joint. So, four members, four frames, one joint. It is in selection. It's all understood or not? Hello?
Got it, sir.
Is that clear? So, that is the way of selection. So, I just want to make the selection of this joint and this joint, because we want to remove this support. We want to remove this support. So drag from right to left. Left to right. So this joint will be selected, one joint. Drag from left to right. So these two joints. Now go to assign. This is why assign. We want to assign something. So go to assign. Go to joint. Go to restrain. Fixity. So we don't see fixed support is there. So all the restraint will be assigned. Considered. If you are going to consider hinge support, so this restraint will be there. If you are going to assign roller, so roller will be there. And this one the nothing, so nothing will be there. So check this one. We don't want any support. Click over this, say apply. Hello. Then drag it from left to right. So this joint will be selected. Say roller one, say apply. Hello.
Yes, sir.
This one is what? Roller one. This left one is what? Hinge one. Right one is what? The roller one. Now close this. If you look here in the question, left one is the hinge one, right one is the roller one. So that is there. Now close this. This is all done. What next thing is there? See, actually this is a continuous line. This is what the continuous line. But in your definition, these two individual members are there, but here we have taken it as a continuous line. So it is right or wrong?
Wrong. Hello? We have to split it.
We have to split it, sir.
We have to divide it. Okay. So how to divide this? So select the frame which you want to divide. Okay. And the joint about which you want to divide it. You want to split it. First, select the frame which you want to split and the joint about which you want to split. Both of the things you have to select. Then go to edit, as it is the edit work. Go to edit and go to edit frames. Go to edit frame, go to divide frame and go to break at intersection with selected frame and joint. Select over these. These are divided into number of frames. We will talk about this in later in detail. Right now, we have to break at the intersection with a selected frame and joint. Now say simply apply. So now it is divided, it is separate. Now it is separate. Understood? Nikita?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Nikita, can you show again the command?
Yes, it will be. First, select the frame which you want to split, then joint. About which you want to split, at which we want to split, then go to edit frames and go to divide frames. As we are apply the means this action to the frame element. So go to frame, go to divide frames, and go to break and intersection with selected frame and joints. Now simply say apply. So it is divided into two parts. Hello. Understood?
Got it, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Now close this. One more thing. See, So this is all done. Our modeling is now okay. Our modeling is now okay. What next thing we have to do? Go back.
Joint.
This is all done. What next thing? Tell me. Actually, we have to, our modeling is now okay. We are going to assign the loading. We are going to assign the loading. So in the truss, all the loads will be at the join. All the loads will be at the join as a point load. So we have to assign this joint load. So go back to etabs. So how many types of the loadings are there? So the point load is there. How many types of loads are there? One is point load. One is point load. Reaction or forces, we are going to consider as point load. Then second one is what? Uniformly distributed load, or we are calling as line load. Line load, uniformly distributed load. And third one is what? UVL, uniformly varying load. Uniformly varying load will be there. And fourth one was area load. Area load, over a particular area loading will be there. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these are the different types of the loads. And in ETAP software, all these kinds of the load you can assign over your structure, over your element, over your point, joint, whatever is there. Okay, so here in this truss, so we have to assign the joint load. In ETAP software, all kinds of the load you can assign. So here is the joint. So what load we have to assign? 2 kN at the tip of this truss. So just drag it from left to right. First select the joint on which you want to assign the load. Then go to assign, go to joint loads, go to force. Joint load, it is what? Force. Click over the force. And two types of the load pattern is there, dead load and live load. Dead load means what? Self weight of the structure. And live load is what? The additional load we are going to assign. Right now, for the understanding, for this discussion, I will talk about the load pattern in detail later. But right now, what? Two load pattern is actually there, dead load and live load. Dead load means what? In simple, consider the self weight of the structure. And live load is what? Hello? Additional load we are going to put, imposed load. So, see, one assumption is also there. While for the truss analysis, the self weight of the structure is neglected. Hello, am I right or wrong? See, in your bachelor, you might be done this while analyzing the structure like beam, slab, truss, whatever, for analysis purpose. So, we are considering the self weight of the member or not? We are not considering the self weight. We are finding the bending moment, shear force, axial forces for the assigned load only. We are not going to calculate the self weight of the member there. Have you remember? In the analysis work, yes, we are considering the self weight of the structure or not? In your bachelor's. No, hello? Tell me. Patil sir.
Only applied load is considered.
Yes. We are considering only joint load. Direct load consider karte the.
Yes, only applied load we are considering. Only applied load we are considering. Nikam, Yogita, Nikita.
Yes, sir.
Only applied load you are considering. Okay, so that we are going to do. Only applied load. Self weight consideration is not there. Don't consider that. Okay, go back. So change it to live. Under which load pattern? Under which load category you want to assign this load? So we want to assign this load under the live load pattern. And this is a global X, global Y, and this is a global Z. So vertically downward direction is there, means over the height. So it is the Z direction. So just click or select this and assign the load. How much? 2 kN. So just go back and put it as 2. Go back and put it as 2. And global. So see, it will be the minus. Minus 2 say apply. Now next, on right and left, it is the 3. So go back, drag it from left to right. Okay, drag it from left to right. One more thing, see, a very important and very basic thing I would like to share. If I'm, see, initially undo. Okay, suppose I'm selecting this and I want to assign -2 kN here and I'm going to say okay. So see, once I click over the okay, so what is going to happen? Yeah, load is going to be assigned. Your operation is done, but your window will be off. Hello, you need to again use that window. So what, again go to select the joint first, then go to assign, then go to join, then go to force. That's a problem. So how to avoid this? So what, undo, select the join, and -2, say apply. So action will be done, but this window will be present here. You can repeat your operation again. Are you getting my point? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then drag it from left to right, drag it from left to right, select the join and change the load from 2 to 3, -3, downward direction, say apply. So this is 2 and this is what, 3 on both of joints. Let's try to understand about these options: add to existing load, replace existing load, delete existing load. Okay, very first, suppose I want to delete this existing load 2 kN from here. So just click here and say apply. Again select this and come undo, delete. So I hope you understand. Suppose I am going to select this, I want by mistake I have assigned this load, so I want to delete this load totally for the live load pattern, say apply. So it will be deleted. Undo, coming back, replace existing load. So whatever the load is there for the particular load pattern, if you want to replace it, suppose by mistake I have assigned 2, it should be 3, suppose it should be 10. So I want to replace it. So what? Simply select this join and let the by default, always it will be by default replace option will be checked. So I would like to change it to 10, from 3 to 10, say 10, -10, sorry, from 2 to 10, say apply. So it is going to be changed to 10. Suppose it is a 10. By mistake I have assigned 10. It is actually 15. It is actually what, 15. So what, instead of directly putting 15, what I would like to do, add to existing load. Add to existing load. So it is 15. How much additionally I need to put here? Hello?
5.
So additional -5 we need to put. Don't do the mistake by taking plus. Additional -5, so -10 plus -5 will become, but these options should be checked. Add to existing load and select the joint, then say apply. Is it okay? Hello?
Yes.
So that is the use of these three options. Now select this joint again, and basically it is what, 2, so change it to 2. And what option should be checked? Replace existing load. So whatever the load is there, that is going to be replaced by the newly defined load. Now say apply simply. It is 2. It's all understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
It's all understood or not?
Yes, understood.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is the application. Now simply say close. So loads we have assigned to all the required joints. So almost all the things are there. Suppose if you want to see these grids, so that will be in view. If you want to off this grid, just right click on the window, set grid system visibility. If you are clicking here, set grid system visibility, so grids will be off. Grids will be not in view. Right click and set grid system visibility, it will be there. Right click, set grid system visibility, it will be off. Right click, set system grid visibility, it will be on.
Yes, clear.
It's clear. So basically what, okay, now what next things we have to see, just right click, set grid system visibility, grids will not be in view. Now next, loading is done, model is done, everything is now okay, nothing is missing. Let me check. Yeah, this is all done. Now we have to check our model is now finalized. We have to check the model whether is there any modeling error or not. Okay, I told you. See, remember, for any step, before of that some settings will be there, then steps you have to perform, and after of that step checks will be there. Before of any action, like suppose you are talking about the modeling, so before of modeling some settings will be there, then you have to perform the modeling, and after the modeling what? After the modeling checks will be there. After the modeling what? Checks will be there. So check we have to perform whether our model is right or wrong. So go to display and go to load assigns. Go to analyze and check model. Go to analyze and check model. Select all of these and say okay. Model has been checked. No warning messages we have generated. Model has been checked. No warning messages were generated. Go to analyze, check model, select all of these and say okay. Model has been checked. No warning messages were generated. Is that clear? So model is perfect. No error, no warnings are there. What next? Tell me.
Run analysis.
Yes, we have to go to perform the analysis. So just perform the analysis. So it is asking to save the model. So just say new folder and say trust. Say 01, save this model. So this is what you have deformed the shape of your structure. Hello. It is what actually the deformed shape of your structure under the application of the loading, how your structure is going to deform. Okay, so this is what I'm going to analyze, how you can perform the analysis. Close this, unlock this. Again, I'm going to perform. See, if you want to start the analysis, you all are with me or not? If you have performed the analysis, what you have to just click over this run analysis. Or in analyze section, run analysis. Just click over the run analysis. So your analysis is going to begin. So this is what deformed the shape of your structure under the application of the loading. So see, under the application of the loading, how your structure will deform. When you take your cursor here, so this will show you deformation. UX, UI, UZ. Can you tell me if you are talking about the 3D model? If you are talking about the 3D model, how many degree of freedom will be there for a particular join?
6.
How many degree of freedom will
six,
be there?
6.
Sana, hello.
6 degree of freedom.
Okay.
Yogita? 3 translation, 3 rotation.
Javed, Faizan. Yes, Yogita.
6 degrees of freedom.
6 degree, okay. Manish?
Yes, sir. 6.
Okay. So basically what? 6 degree of freedoms will be there. What does mean the degree of freedom? There is a possibility of movement of that joint along that direction. The possibility of movement of the joint about along that direction. Okay. So suppose if you are talking about this joint. So it is having the possibility of translation in X direction. So we are going to call it as UX. This is having the possibility of movement along this direction, call it as UI. The possibility of the rotation movement along this Z direction, say UZ, UX, UY, UZ. And there is a movement, possibly the movement about the MX, possibly the movement about the Y direction, possibly the movement about the Z direction. So total what it is going to become? What it is going to become? It is the 6 degree of freedom.
6.
So that all results, if you take your cursor from here to here, that will be available. UX, UI, UZ, RX, RY, RZ. Understood? So in X direction, that much movement is there, translation is there in y direction, in z direction maximum, -0.227, because only the gravitational loading is there. That's why shifting in the gravitational direction is more. So this is the what? If you want to see the animated shape of this deformed structure under the loading, say start animation. As you can see, the translational movement is fixed. Translational movement is not allowed on hinge support, but it is a roller support. It is shifting in this direction. Hello? Understood,
yes,
or
sir.
Not?
You understood, sir.
You understood? So this is what actually you need to understand, basically. This is you need to understand. Next is what? Okay, we have to see the result. We have to see the result in the member. Okay, so go back to your question. Forces in the member. So I told you, all the frames are actually loaded, means subjected to actual forces. That may be either our nature may be either tension or compression. Either suppose if you are talking about the truss member, this is what truss member. So it may be subjected to sometimes of tension force, and sometimes may be subjected to compressive force. Sometimes may be subjected to compressive force, tension force and compressive force. Okay, these two nature of the loading will be there. Go back to this. So I want to see the result. First, before of that, we need to look for the reaction. So go to display, go to force stress diagram. See, in the display, force stress diagram, go to support reaction, and I would like to see for live load. This is for the case, what types of the loads are there, dead load, live load and all. So I would like to see for the live, in the arrow format, in the Z direction, say apply. So on left end, 4 kN, on right end, it is 4 kN. Let's check your question, 4 and 4, is it right or wrong?
Correct.
Is it right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now next is what? Try to understand. So reaction is okay. Now close this and just click over show undeformed shape, normal shape, or in display just click over undeformed shape, normal situation. So this was normal. And once your analysis gets completed, one more thing, remember, I forget to say, once your analysis gets completed, your model will be logged. Your model will be logged. You can't do anything in the modeling. You can't do any change because your analysis has been done. Got it? Now next. Next is what? Hinge support and roller support. Hinge support and roller support. Next. Hinge support and roller support. And we want to see the reaction. So go to display, force stress diagram, frame pier and spindle forces. As you know that these all are the frame element, so go to frame under the live load. I would like to see the actual force. What does it mean by the torsion? What does it mean by the shear? 2, 2, 3, 3. We'll discuss it in detail later. But right now, we want to see the actual forces in the member. So go to check this option, actual one. Now simply say apply. See, actual one, this will be the automatic scaling field diagram. What does it mean the field diagram? You will understand. Then include frame. We want to see the result for the frame. Say apply. Close this. So this is what the result we are having. Red color is showing the compressive force. Hello. Red color is showing the compressive force. Yellow color is showing the tension force, tensile force. Red color is showing the compressive force. Yellow color is showing the tensile force. And yellow color is showing the, means the values are also there. 5.19 means it is positive, means tension. When you take your cursor here, it is minus 4 like that. Minus 4, minus 6 like this. So it is what? negative force. Negative force means compressive. This is positive means tension. Yellow color means tension. Red color means compressive. If you want to show the values also, if you want to see the values, check these options. Show values at controlling station. Say apply. So the values will be there. So values will also be there for the loading, or for the result, for the reactions, for the internal forces. Uncheck this field diagram. Uncheck this. Say apply. So only the values will be there. Field diagram color will not be there. So uncheck this. Say apply. Field diagram only. So this much reactions are there. This much forces, internal forces of the members are there. So we have to check it with the result. So in the AB, let me show you. In the AB, how much force is there? AB 6.92. Nature is what? Tension. Here is the nature is what? Tension. So it is right or wrong? Fast.
Right, sir.
Right. Nature is tension. Okay. Now what about the value? If the value is what? 6.928, and what result we are getting? 6.9. Actual result is 6.9, almost 7, and we are getting 5 only. 5.19 means almost 5. It is 5. So will you accept it is right? Hello.
No.
Is it right? Will you accept this?
No.
Give me answer fast. Don't take much time.
No, sir.
No, it is wrong. Okay. Check for others also. Yeah, B to C, tension is there. Okay. 3.46. Okay. 3.46. It is okay. 3.48. Okay, we can consider. We can consider.
Yes, sir.
Now, check for this. Here it is 6.45. Right click over this. How much it is? If you want to see more elaborated view, more elaborated result, just right click over the member. Just right click over the member. So this will give you more elaborated result. 6.49 means 6.5 approximately. 6.5 load is there. And here A to G. 6.5 is there. And here it is what? 8. Will you accept this?
No, sir.
No. So what's the problem? Overall, I can say that it is wrong. I can say or not.
It may be possible digits are considered.
No, that's not an issue. Because if you are going to correct the digits, so see, here it is showing what? 6. Right click 6. And actual result is 8. So how will you adjust this? Are you getting my point? 2 kilonewton difference is there. Totally.
Yes.
Okay. So that is not an issue of digits consideration. Tell me, will you accept this result? Overall, your result is wrong. So where
no,
we
sir.
Did the mistake? Everything we have done correct. Where we did the mistake? Sana, do you have any idea? Yes, Aman.
Material property.
Sorry.
Section property decide नहीं किया
है. No, property decide करने का problem ही नहीं है. Because see, हम लोगों ने dead load को consider ही नहीं कर रहे हैं. हम लोग live load देख रहे हैं. So let's see what actually the problem. Try to understand. Very important. You all are with me.
Type up.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Who is there?
Type up join.
Type up join means.
Joined, sir.
Okay, you
joining
are
up.
You are close. Patil?
Need to consider joint which is not allowed to rotate. Only translation movement are allowed in each and every joint where support are not provided.
Yes,
need to
try to understand. Actually, one more thing, just concentrate. Why? Because go to display. Frame. See, the result you are getting 6.4. This result you are getting 6.4 and actual is 8. Here you are getting 6.4, actual is 8. Here you are getting what? 5. And actual is what? 6. Actual is what? 6. Means you are getting the value less than of the actual. Am I right or wrong?
Right.
Difference is there, but difference is less. Means your actual value is less than of your actual result of the tabs is less than of the actual result. Here because it is 6.4 and it is 8. It is 5. It is less than of 6. So less value we are getting. Why? Because see, try to understand. Actually, this joint tabs considering as fixed joint. Hello?
Yes.
ETABS is considering this joint as fixed joints. This joint as fixed joints. This joint as fixed joint. Why? Because, see, whenever you are going to model in ETABS software like this, any frame, one frame is like this, another frame is going to be raised over this. So, this joint is what? Fixed one. This joint is what? Fixed one. By default, we are considered by the software. But what assumption is there for the analysis of the truss? All the joints, all the connections are pinned connection. All the members are connected their ends by the pinned connection means what? They are not able to carry any movement. Hello? They are not able to, suppose fixed support is there. So that fixed support is capable of carrying the movement. But here hinge support is there. Here hinge support is there. So this hinge support is not capable of carrying the movement. It can transfer only the axial forces. It can transfer only the axial forces. It is not capable of carry any movement. But in ETAB software, it is considering a fixed joint, means it is considering the movement. So, aapka yahan par kya ho raha hai? Movement ko carry kar lena hai. And the stresses where released to the member is less. Stresses where released to the member is less. Because some stresses were carried by this fixed support. Are you getting my point? Hello? That's why there will be the less stress or less force to your member. But in manual calculation, we are not consider the movement carrying capacity of this joint. Because this joint is a hinge or pinned. That's why we are having the more forces in the member. Am I right or wrong? Hello? Patil, Arun?
Yes, right.
Javed? Is that clear or not? Or is there any confusion to anyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, looking back, clear this all. So, actually, we need to make it as, we have to release the movement from here. We have to make it as pinned joint. We have to make it as what? Pinned joint. Got it? So, that we have to do. So select this frame, select this frame, this one, select all of these frame to be selected. Then go to assign, go as it is the frame element. So go to frame and here releases and partial fixity. Check this option and on left end and on right end, on both of the end, we want to release the movement so that this joint will not carry any movement. Select this. How to do this? First, select the frame, go to assign, go to frame, go to releases and partial fixity on left side, on right side, both of the end. I want to release for all the members. Say apply. I will talk about the releases later, okay? But right now, just follow the step. Now, say apply. Now, it is finally going to become actually free from carrying the movement. Now it is the pinned connection, hinge connection. Is that okay? Hello?
Yes.
Is that okay or not? Now go to analyze and now perform the analysis, the run analysis. Just say close. go to display force stress diagram, frame and piers, say apply. Is it visible? Now see, how much force is there? 6.92. What's your actual result? 6.92, exactly matching or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Here it is representing 8. Minus 8, exactly. 100% yes, matching. Sir. Okay. Next to that, here 1.7321. Tension. 1.73. BF and FC. BF and FC. Tension. 1.73. Is it right or wrong?
Right, sir.
Is that clear? FE. Where yes, FE? Sir. FE. Where it is? FE. This one. Here it is what showing? FE 5 kN compressive force. This one, FE 5 kN compressive force. Is that clear? Hello? So your ATAPS is giving the right result or not? Hello?
Yeah, 100%.
Right, okay, so that is actually the validation. And many things we have to do. So, this is all about today. If you have any question and doubt, you can ask.
Clear. All clear.
Okay. Sir, while you are explaining about slabs, I wrote one thing. What is the term between base and ground floor, sir? Between this, what we call the term?
Bottom story height, not dump.
Between base and ground floor, sir.
Between base
base ground to ground floor.
Yes. Yeah. Bottom story height.
Bottom story height, okay, yes. Thank you.
Patel sir?
Yeah, it's clear.
Yeah, be present. Now all you can leave the meeting.